welcome you as Forum Boxing Incorporated and Budweiser, the undisputed king of beers, presents the main event of the evening, a lightweight special attraction scheduled for 10 rounds of boxing. This bout is sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission. Their chairman is William Eastman, commissioner in attendance Jerry Nathanson, and the executive officer is Richard DeCure. Presenting the judges as appointed at ringside, Dick Young, Larry Rosadilla, Patrick Russell, and the referee in charge of this bout, Lou Moretz. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening, lightweights in action, 10 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you first on my right, he is fighting out of the blue corner in this featured bout, wearing blue trunks with white trim, hailing from Mexico City, Distrito Federal, Mexico. He weighed in at 135 and 3 quarter pounds. With a record of 26 wins, 12 losses, and 1 draw, he has 20 wins coming by way of knockout. He is the former WBO lightweight champion of the world. Please welcome Mauricio Aceves. And his opponent across the ring, on my left in the red corner, he enters the ring wearing multicolored trunks and hailing from Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico. His weight, 136 pounds. His record, 49 wins, 6 losses, 4 draws with 34 knockouts. Here is the former IBF featherweight champion. Please welcome the colorful clown prince of boxing, introducing Jorge Maromero Paez. Once again, here's your referee in charge, Lou Moretz.
Por favor, súbelos de aquí. Aquí es la frontera, ¿eh? ¿Tienen preguntas? Para la campaña.
The tail of the tape for the clown prince of boxing. First of all, Paez is 5'6", Aceves 2 inches taller. 136 pounds, 135 and 3 quarters, little to choose from there. Paez is 5 years younger and has 3 inches in the reach department. It was kind of a sedate Maromero Paez who bowed to all four corners of the compass, all 4 points, northeast, south, and west, as we get ready for round number one. Lou Moretz, the referee. Larry Rosadilla, Dick Young, and Pat Russell are the judges at ringside who'll be scoring the fight. Paez goes into, you know, he has got something new. He's got a bag of tricks, unbelievable, that he brings out for every fight.
And first minute of the fight, he usually clowns a lot, and then he starts getting serious. In this fight, he might clown all the way, because I don't think Save is going to get it.
You know, he's a piece of work, there's no question about it. Aside from all of that, aside from all of this, that as you laughing, grinning, applauding, and what have you, this cat can fight. He is a fighter. 46 wins, 49 wins, and only 6 losses. And his fight and a try for the IBF lightweight title with Freddie Pendleton, a fight I did in Vegas, was a corking good one. Pendleton put him down twice, cut him both times, and yet he was still there when the bell sounded for the last round, battling away at Pendleton.
I was there that night. He put up a tough fight. His Pendleton was just too big and quick for him.
Goes into a little dance in the corner. The crowd loves it.
He's a natural featherweight.
That's right.
He's fighting
right.
A lightweight now. And that's why he's had some trouble with lightweights. When he went up, remember, he fought Tony Lopez.
That's right.
Got beat at 130 pounds. Now he's fighting at 135, of course.
Yeah, and it goes Rafael Ruelas. Beat him here, the Great Western Forum, and put him away. In fact, he couldn't come out for the
good combination.
All of a sudden, after about 45 seconds of a little shake and bake, warms up to the task and is just out muscling out everything Mauricio Aceves.
This is a very big fight for Paez. If he wins this fight and one more, then this summer he has a lucrative match against Slated against Mr. Oscar De La Hoya.
Well, I tell you, that, as I said in our opening moments on camera, that is a promoter's dream, I would think. When you consider the popularity of this young guy, the obvious popularity of the East L.A. golden boy from Barcelona, Oscar De La Hoya. I tell you, I don't know if is the Coliseum going to be ready? Do you think we can throw him in the middle of that, huh?
That one winds up.
Shades of Mondo Ramos. That'd be a pretty good fight, wouldn't it?
That would be a very lucrative pay-per-view fight, no doubt about that.
Yeah. A flurry of punches by Paez, who spent about 30 seconds clowning around to open this fight, opening round, and as a savist now, stalks him, so to speak, while Paez walks away, and that's the end of round number one, which I would think he won as he outpunched the Savas. We'll go into the corner with Paez, Hector Gill, Tony Campos, Chuck Bodak, of course. He had the interesting hairdos as well. Chuck Bodak gets really involved. Best cut man in the business.
He certainly is. Chuck Bodak, 78 years old.
You're kidding, I didn't realize.
I didn't think so either. I thought he was in his late 50s, early 60s.
Watch Paez again. He gets you looking at that right hand and then bang, hits you with the left and then about four more rights. The old now you see it, now you don't. Look over here, the sleight of hand, the magician's trick, huh? The other side of the ring, we've got Mauricio Aceves. Mauricio, as they get ready for round number two, has had an interesting career. He's fallen on kind of barren times of late. He hasn't fought much. Last time he was in the ring was 16 months ago, and it's only the second time in over 2 years, so he might be rusty, of course.
August 30th, 1989 was a big date for Aceves. That's the last time he won a fight.
The Bahanas brothers, they were the toast of the town for a while. Doug Gregorian.
They certainly were.
Kiko. Oscar.
I saw Kiko the night he fought. It was Alberto Davila.
Mm-hmm. Flurry of punches by Paez. Reaches out and touches gloves with the Savas. I've done a lot of Paez's fights, Doug. I've been privileged to watch him in action. I must admit I'm a fan of his. I think he's a very fine fighter. But he does a lot of things that I like in the ring. If he has a man hurt, he will actually turn to the referee and let him know that this guy is hurt and I don't care to hurt him any further. And he would not, I don't think he would deliberately take advantage of a fighter who was helpless.
He's a sporting fighter, despite his histrionics.
He's
very professional in that regard. He's throwing very good combinations right now.
He
looks sharp.
Yep. He is smaller, of course, 5'6", than the 5'9", or 5'8", Aceves. And, of course, as a lightweight at 135 pounds, there are lightweights that are taller. Rafael Ruelas for one. In fact, there's the junior lightweight who I think is really a great champion. Genaro Hernandez at 5'11 at 130 pounds, who I think is just a classic champion.
Very good fighter. I'd like to see him get his world.
Just do it, really.
Certainly.
Yeah. Bit by bit, the fans of Los Angeles and the world are coming to know about him, but he has long toiled in anonymity in an undefeated career in a world championship. That seems strange.
Well, you know he's a pretty good fighter. De La Hoya's camp doesn't want to have anything to do with
that. Oscar was here, and of course his future is still very much ahead of him. But he was here the night that Hernandez put Raul Perez Ibarro down with the left hand to the liver. That was devastating. De La Hoya suddenly decided that 135 would be a better weight than 130.
That's for sure. Paez landing's a very good combination.
Yes, he is.
By beating Aceves to the punch.
But you know, Aceves is not really backing up. He's right in front of him and trying as the round comes to a close.
If you were De La Hoya's people, Tom, would you fight Paez later this summer?
Yes. Yeah, I would. I really would. And I tell you, I think De La Hoya is being handled quite properly. I must tell you, I was frankly a little disappointed he didn't put Breedall away. I thought he should have cut the ring off against Bredahl better, and I thought Bredahl was available to be knocked out, and De La Hoya did not do it. But a win is a win, and as you know, there are fighters for fighters, and sometimes it's a lot easier to sit and criticize a fight than it is to get in there and try to chase a guy for 12 rounds or 10 rounds and corner him. I think Oscar's got a great future in front of him.
I
would put him in with Paez because it'll be a big payday. I don't know if Paez can hit hard enough to hurt him, you know what I mean?
I agree with you, and I think he hits too hard for Paez.
Yep. He's taller. I tell you, it would be a classic fight for the fans. They would just love it, I think.
What would they fight at, 130, 135?
I think it had 35. I don't 35. Think Paez can get to 130. And I think Oscar is going to grow to be 135. I think he's going to grow to be 140, maybe. 100, you know. He's got a pretty good-sized frame. Well,
he got, butt.
Yeah, clash of heads.
Paez has a little nick on his right eye. It's, I don't think it's bleeding yet, but it's on the threshold.
Yeah. And Aceves above us here, I think he's all right. They touch gloves. I don't see blood coming anywhere, but...
A little bruise though.
Yep. Well, they're teeing off on one another now. Round number three. Neither man has been down.
Aceves is willing, and he's come to fight.
Yes, he has. And as I hate to use the word caution, but as we cautioned you, you know, he's only been in, this is only the second time he's been in the ring in a little over 2 years. He's been in against some of the very best in the division. He was a former champion. Paez hit him low and kind of apologized for it. And when he's right, when he's ready to fight, Aceves is still a very formidable opponent.
He is, and the cut around Paez's right eye is ready to open up.
Paez hit him again, a low shot, kind of down near Mexicali, really. Toe to toe. Aceves is not giving an inch nor backing up. Paez, quick-handed. It's the third round, scheduled for 10.
Aceves is definitely not intimidated by Jorge Paez.
No.
Outgunned, yes, but not in
yes. Yeah. Right there, toe to toe, forehead to forehead, wailing away at one another as we come to the end of round three. More action from the Great Western Forum in a moment. In the corner of Jorge Paez and the same across the way with Mauricio Aceves. This is the headbutt that occurred earlier. As you see, the two foreheads come together. Here's another look at it.
Chuck Bodak has already worked his magic on Paez. You don't see any bleeding in the right eye.
Aceves has got almost movie star good looks, hasn't he? He's a handsome youngster. Into the ring tonight, 33 years of age. He's been around.
Yeah, for a man that's had 39 professional fights, he is remarkably unmarked.
Yeah. I thought as I watched him go back to the corner after round number three, he looked just a bit weary. Why not? He's been very busy, and he's been in against a guy who is very, very busy. Jorge Paez to save us.
He certainly does. And he has not lost any quickness.
No. I think Aceves got for a moment they butted heads again. That's
good comedy.
Yeah.
Good left, good right.
And
Paez is a very sound professional fighter. Has good uppercuts, good combination. Moves his head. He knows the way he moves his head very well. He's a real professional. You can see why he was the former featherweight champion of the world.
That's right. Jorge Paez in the, what else? Multicolored trunks. Mauricio Aceves, blue and white. Oh, nice combination.
body would fight.
Yes. Considering his inactivity, one wonders how long this can go on. But, you know, they are just literally taking turns, kind of showing their wares.
I'm not sure Paez can hurt Seamus. Seamus is a natural lightweight. Remember, Paez was a former featherweight.
That's right. He's, yeah, that has been, and as the years go on, why it becomes the biggest question mark about him, can he take a legitimate 135-pounder and knock him down or knock him out? I remember the fight he had with the now IBF champion, Rafael Ruelas, in the fifth round of that one, Doug. I think you were here.
Right.
He hit Ruelas with, I mean, a classic shot, and Ruelas was against the ropes to our left over here and looked for all the world like he was going to go, but Paez could not take it any further. Ruelas managed to clear his head, went on, and won the fight in convincing time.
Right. That's when the mouthpiece came out, Martin Dinkin, I think.
Yep.
Stopped the fight for a few seconds.
Well, what a busy round, a very good round by two very accomplished fighters. That brings us to the end of round number four, and the judges are going to have a good time scoring this one. The men at ringside, Larry Rosadilla, Dick Young to our right, Pat Russell, and of course the man in the ring, Lou Moret, does not do any of the scoring, but he's there to make sure things go according to plan.
Do you think the referees should score?
No, I don't. I think they've got enough. They've got enough to do out there just to take care of the fighters and to make sure that things are handled. Seamus, as we said earlier, he kind of, it looked there like now he's going to look at the referee and say, you know, I just got butted. And the referee, Lou Moret, says, let's get on with it again.
That was hard to determine who caused that fight.
Yeah.
He moved into Paez.
See, that ration of punches there by Perez, not very good. All right, Doug, scoring brought to you by Super Lotto, the game that's made millionaires out of 624 of you Californians. Has Paez ahead 40-36 after four rounds, which meant he's given every round to the Clown Prince.
You agree with it?
I don't have it 40-36. In fact, I gave the last round to Seamus. Excuse me, I gave him the third round.
Okay.
So I've... look at Paez.
Well, somebody said something to him out of the crowd, and he grabbed a hold of Seamus and turned and smiled and said, you're absolutely right.
But you notice that he was smart enough to grab a save so he couldn't get hurt while he was pointing to the crowd.
You know, he's a very good defensive fighter. Watch the way he moves his head. He's skilled in moving his head, which is a lost art among a lot of modern fighters, Tom.
Mauricio Aceves, I think, is doing a very fine job fighting here tonight. All things considered, he's been out of the ring a long time. His career at 33 years of age would appear to be behind him. I don't mean that to denigrate his talents or his great record, but he is 33.
Paez is so much quicker than he is.
Yep.
Paez is really opening up right now. He's landed
a series of solid shots.
Very good combination. I'm not sure he could hurt him.
Well, you know, just the number of punches and the attrition could very well take care of Aceves, because Paez has hit him a lot of shots.
Aceves fought Roger Mayweather, was stopped in three rounds.
Yeah.
Mayweather was champion.
Aceves has got a pretty good mouse under his left eye.
Good left hook.
Yeah.
Paez.
Oh, look at those. About two to the body, and then right straight up to the jaw.
But he's having no effect on it.
Well, now we come back to whether or not can he really put 135-pounder down and out. Is he able to, kind of a puncher, doesn't take a lot of him. Punches, that is. And
he's here to save us with everything and hasn't buckled his knees yet. And that makes you wonder if he does have the power.
Very good point. He has really nailed him with some of his best shots. And Aceves has felt him, but he has not given sign of knees coming together, wobble leg, rubber leg, or anything like that.
and the Sabres just keeps coming forward.
We're coming to the end of round number 5. It is scheduled for 10, and we'll be back. So round number 6, the Sabres comes running out of his corner. They touch gloves. The Sabres is in the blue, trimmed in white. Of course, you know Jorge Maromero Paez.
Watch Jorge Paez. You really get intrigued by him fighting Oscar De La Hoya.
Yes.
He does this kind of clowning against De La Hoya. Will it upset De La Hoya? Will it cause him problems?
Well, it could. I think anybody who agrees to get into the ring with Paez has to realize that he's going to be subjected to this. That probably the only time, Doug, that he did not really engage in anything weird and colorful like he's doing for the most part. But the night he fought Pendleton up in Las Vegas,
very serious. Well, he knew he couldn't goof off if he was going to stay in vertical position.
No. Well, even though Pendleton knocked him down twice, I thought he fought a very good fight.
He was throwing wild left hooks right there. Remind me of Floyd Patterson.
Yeah.
You know, the leaping left hook?
That's right. From behind the peekaboo defense, jump out and throw a left hand at you.
Yeah. He does have an assortment of different punches.
Everything in the book. He's got all the moves.
Good left.
Look at that. There's about 5 or 6.
He threw 5 left hooks.
Yeah.
You never see that, Bob. You never see that.
Davis slipped over there, wet on that side of the ring. Now Paez walks away from him.
Of course, he does things you never see, like kiss the ring card, girls, between rounds.
Or what he does there, just watch. When I would think now, to give both sides of the coin here, fighters who get into the ring with him might really be irritated when he has a tendency to show utter disdain for him by turning around and walking away or mugging for the crowd, that type of thing. Fighters place a great deal of substance on the word respect.
Right, I agree, but he doesn't really mock his opponents that much. He doesn't direct his mockery at the opponents. Sometimes he does, but basically, he looks out towards the crowd. In other words, what you're saying is that his actions alone mock his opponent.
Yeah. But he operates on the theory that he's here to give the crowd a show for the money they've spent to watch him in action, and he is literally a performer in that sense of the word. Been a long career, 49 wins, only six losses.
Acevis is willing and has fought much better than we all expected.
And that's the end of round number 6. It is scheduled for 10. Every time you see Paez fight, of course, you think about, is he in condition? Has he taken this one seriously? Chuck Bodak will be working on that slight abrasion above the right eye. Doctor is in checking on the condition of Acevis. Doctor says he's all right. Does he want to continue in Acevis? I didn't see any indication he wanted to quit, Doug.
No, not at all.
No.
He hasn't backed off at all. He's taken all the punches. Obviously, Paez dominated this fight. I have him pitching a shutout.
Yeah. Here's Paez. Left.
Four.
Yeah.
Four left hooks in a row.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And missing the right.
See, there's the Floyd Patterson leaping left hook. That's what Patterson knocked out Archie Moore with. Remember that?
Acevis must think from time to time that he's run into a runaway propeller or something. Keeps flailing away on him. It's only the Clown Prince, Maromero Paez, getting ready, and the bell brings them together for round number 7. It's scheduled for 10.
You know, I notice he has a 72-inch reach.
Yeah.
And Marciano only had a 68-inch reach.
Well, he was a short-armed heavyweight, to be sure. He also, God rest his soul, had no
connecting rods from his jaw to his brain. I mean, Ezra Charles hit him with a left hook that opened his nose up. You could have put a cigar in the cut from stem of his nose right up to the bridge of it. And I don't think Marciano even blinked. Speaking of great left hands, Ezra Charles had one.
Certainly did. Well, Ezra Charles is a great light heavyweight.
Yep.
People don't realize he beat Archie Moore, I believe, 3 or 4 times.
Yep.
You know, he weighed 182 pounds. He was heavyweight champ.
Seventh round scheduled for 10. Neither man has been down.
This is the first time Paez looking a little weary.
Well, conditioning always. Lou Moret cautions him against holding, I guess.
Sabas still coming.
Oh, yeah.
He's a plotter. He's not very quick.
No.
And his face is very bruised at this moment.
Now it is, yep.
He does have a pug's face.
Oh, yes, now he does, yeah. We're going to have to shoot around him for film for the next 2 or 3 weeks while the swelling goes down. But he's got some abrasions under both eyes now.
Throwing left hooks to the body, and he connected with a hook to the jaw a moment ago.
Paez kind of just sits there, gloves across his face, covering up like that. Playing possum, suddenly could explode with a flurry of punches. Like that. Drive his man back.
He's breathing heavily through his mouthpiece right now, Paez.
Doing a remarkable job, I think, for a man who was last in the ring 16 months ago and whose biggest night might have been as far back as 4.5 years ago in 89 when he beat Oscar Bejanos in the 10th round after being behind. He knocked Bejanos out. He would have to reach back and catch lightning in a bottle again, I would think, to do likewise tonight.
I don't think he's going to knock out Jorge Paez.
No, I don't either.
He's certainly not embarrassing himself.
Oh, no. He's fought very hard. This is a very tough fight for him. Seventh round is coming to a close, and I think he's had his best round. We'll be back after this. As we get set for round 9, we'll take a look back at a flurry these two men had to close out round 8. I mean, all of a sudden, for about the last 5 or 6 seconds, including the bell, these two guys went at each other like it was a free lunch counter up there. Go ahead.
How many of Paez's punches landed there in that combination like they did earlier in the fight? He's tired.
Well, I don't think we want to belabor the point, but we must point out the fact that Aceves has put up a magnificent fight here tonight. Just got nailed with a good left hand from Paez. But here's a guy who is fighting for the second time in 29 months. He's 33 years of age.
He hasn't taken backwards.
No, he has.
Entire fight. Despite taking a pummel.
Yep. Both cheekbones are swollen. Been a headbutt or two that has not been of any consequence except annoying and I'm sure painful, irritating to the two men.
I was there the evening that he was knocked out by Roger Mayweather, and his fans booed him lustily as he left the ring. Well, they're not going to boo him tonight.
What a crushing blow that is, especially for an Hispanic fighter, a crowd, and of course a former champion too. Here the crowd, I tell you, Paez reacts when the crowd boos too. He just that's a cutting blow for him.
Roger Mayweather knocked out a lot of guys.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
His career. Of course, he did knock out Julio Cesar Chavez. He knocked him out a couple of times.
You know, there's about a dozen rematches coming up. Everybody is, huh?
Certainly
what do you think of that?
Well, I think Julio Cesar Chavez is going to beat Frankie Randall.
You do?
Yes, and I think Simon Brown will beat Terry Norris again.
How about Azuma Nelson?
Jesse Lee, I think, Azuma Nelson.
Why are they giving him Leon another shot at that?
Politics of boxing, Tom. You don't have enough time to discuss that.
Is it wonderful?
Once again, Paez asserting his dominance.
And then Aceves comes back with a half a dozen shots of his own, and then takes two right hands from Paez. Boy, that was a low blow.
Paez's punches are not hurting Aceves.
The left hand drives him back, though, and then a right hand.
As many times as Paez has hit him, you think it's knocked him down at least once.
That's right.
He's never buckled his knee.
No.
That's why I think De La Hoya would beat him. He'd be too big for him.
Well, in the age factor, Paez would have to be, I think even he would admit, in the best shape of his life. Because at 28, though he's not old, it is a young man's game, this boxing. Unless you're a heavyweight. They like middle distance runners and what have you mature later in life, I think. That is, are able to fight past their, you know, 28, 29, 30, 31, along in there, 33, 34. Or in the case of Foreman, forever.
Which makes Azuma Nielsen incredible.
Yeah.
He's 35 years old, and he's still very effective.
Well, these two have got one more round to go. Aceves' his corner over there. Trying to get their man ready for three more minutes. They come together at the center of the ring, and I tell you, they've got great respect for one another. Did you notice there was no conning around, no derisive looks or remarks or anything like that? It was just, and now Paez trying to, look at him. He looks like something that the Bolshoi Ballet threw away, doing those high splits.
Well, he's going to clown this last round. He knows he's won just about every round.
Yep.
As well as.
Yep.
He's going to have some fun.
Well, Lumaret steps in and says,
"Lou, Lou didn't want to see any jumping jacks.
No.
First time I've ever seen a boxer do jumping jacks in the ring."
Now you see the crowd is pro Paez. They love to see these antics.
Lumaret's got to show a sense of humor. Now come on, Lou.
Davis, in the meantime, is all business. I'm sure he's not too crazy about watching the guy next to him in the 10th round doing a series of jumping jacks.
When he goes into this clown mode of his, notice how he uses his defensive skills. And that's what he really shows, that he moves his head. I'm very impressed with his defensive tactics.
Yeah, he'll carry his hands right down at the side of his thighs and never get hit. Slip and slide.
He moves his head.
Yeah. See, he steps in, goes left-handed, Doug, and then throws a left and lands an uppercut and then walks away.
He's a skilled practitioner, no doubt about it. And he's well on his way to a summer match with Oscar De La Hoya, which should be very intriguing. He needs to win one more fight in June, and then he'll qualify for it. Chuck Kodak, frankly, wonders why the De La Hoya fight wants a fight. He thinks it's too dangerous. Do you agree with him?
I don't think he can beat De La Hoya. But you know, this may be for Paez, that fight. How do you describe some of those moves?
Well,
I guess you don't. You just sit and watch them.
The classic Jorge Paez we're witnessing right now.
Yeah.
But see, Aceves has hit him. If De La Hoya hits him like that, it's going to hurt him. That's going to be the difference.
Outside of that WBO title that De La Hoya has, do you think he'll have? Well, took a point away.
Lumaret.
Yeah, took a point away.
Lumaret, where's your sense of humor?
We've only got 13 seconds left here in round number 10.
News from the old boxing school.
Boy, Paez landed a solid right hand. If, I mean, in the 10th round. A punch like that, and the Savis didn't go down. Punching power may be the one suspect item in his considerable, among his considerable talents, especially against a bona fide 135 pounder. It'll be interesting, that fight with De La Hoya. All right, we'll get the official report. We think that the Clown Prince is another winner here tonight. We'll be back to get it official in just a moment. Don't go away. Fight Night at the Forum is brought to you by Restore Automotive Products, manufacturers of innovative products for the automotive do-it-yourselfer. By the Mash from Fila. Fila changed the game. And by Caesar's Palace, home of the April 22nd Holyfield Moore World Heavyweight Championship bout. Well, we're ringside here at the Great Western Forum. Crowd on its feet. Waiting now. Lou Moret, who's as good an official as there is, came over. Doug Gregorian says Lou doesn't have a sense of humor, but Lou took a point away from Baez for clowning in round number 10.
I love Lou. He's a good guy.
I think Baez won the fight anyway. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr. He'll tell us how the judges saw it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing, we have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Larry Rosadilla scores at 98-91. Pat Russell and Dick Young both score at 97-92. All three in favor of the winner, Jorge Maromero Paez.
So a unanimous decision win for Jorge Maromero Paez. Our congratulations, of course, to Aceves, who we thought fought a very valiant fight. For a man who's not been that active in the ring at age 33, he was a classic competitor tonight, and he put up a great show. And the two men now congratulate each other. But whatever you might think of Paez and his strange and sometimes hilarious, maybe even irritating antics in the ring, he's a real sportsman when it comes to his opponents. He is not out there deliberately to hurt him, and he always has a class move for them at the end of the fight, win or lose. He doesn't lose much. This is number 50 for his career in the win column. Fernando Paramo is with the Clown Prince. Let's go to the center of the ring.
Jorge, an excellent fight for, you know, in order to get ready for Oscar De La Hoya. Una excelente pelea para en preparación para Oscar De La Hoya.
Así es, nomás que la gente poquito se metió conmigo porque quería que noqueara. No, yo no quería nada, pues tuviste. Nomás me la empecé a llevar, para mí. Para ir pues, haciendo las cosas como debe ser para la pelea de no sé si es Oscar o si es Rafael Ruela, no sé. Quien sea.
Well, first of all,
los gringos, everybody, homeboy.
That's the matter who he fights. He says that, he says maybe the people start getting on his case, but he was fighting this fight, try to make it go the distance and try to get ready for Oscar or for Ruelas or for anybody that might be next. Do you want anybody in particular? ¿Quieres alguien en particular que siga?
No, ninguno. Yo nomás lo único en particular que hay es la feria. Yo siempre la feria. A mí vale quien sea. Si me pegan ni pedo, si me pegan ni modo, me van a pegar, me van a ganar o voy a ganar yo una de las dos.
¿No? He says, doesn't matter who it is, as long as he gets the money. He says that he's there for the money, whether or not who, it doesn't matter. If he wins, he gets money. If he loses, he gets money. Doesn't matter to him. ¿Cuándo will be your next fight? ¿Cuándo será tu siguiente pelea?
A la noche. No, pero yo creo, no sé, estoy esperando más que me digan, se habla mucho con Oscar De La Hoya, poco con Rafael Ruelas, con quien sea, no me importa quien sea, más que me paguen y órale.
Okay, he says a lot of talk against Oscar, against Ruelas, it doesn't matter as long as they paid.
Antes de todo, voy a pelear con mi vieja.
Spoken like a true professional. Thank you, Fernando. Our congratulations to you. How about a little exercise in round number 9? Gonna cost you a point. He's a winner, number 50 in a brilliant career, the Clown Prince, Jorge.